Pete Rose called up and he said, "Hey, dummy, Bob," he said, he was out the other night. Carolyn didn't know it. Maybe I shouldn't tell this story. He went over to the, is it the Riverview guys? Is that the Riverside? Riverfront. Riverfront Holiday Inn. The same people own that and own the one downtown and the one north and south. The only difference is they haven't put a roof over their swimming pool yet. But these guys do well. That happens next week. But Pete was over there, and Pete called the next day, and he said, "Bob," and I said, "Pete." He said, "I heard the best group I've heard in a club in a long time over at the Holiday Inn Riverfront, and I'd like you to have them on the show."
Hey, good.
Right. And I said, "Okay, Pete. I mean, anybody would get on television in front of the world and say his wife takes Geritol. I'll do anything he says." Right.
Right.
And anybody get in it. What is that other? He sings that commercial for, what is that?
Aquaville.
Aquaville.
Right, right.
Aquavelva, yes.
Aquavelva.
Aquavelva. Can you say doggy? Anyhow, Pete said these guys were just great, and they had them come over here. They've got an album out called Waterfront Live, and their name is Waterfront. And on the back, it says right here, it says, "Holding this Waterfront Live album in your hands means that you're only one step away from hearing one of the most dynamic new recording groups in America." That's heavy, Jess.
I guess, yeah.
You want to produce them? Just, they're just Waterfront. Any way you want to.
Waterfront.
No, do more than that, Jess. Okay. Here, you present.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Riverfront, we'd like for you to now sit back and relax. Enjoy Waterfront.
said dance. I said dance, everybody dance. I said dance, everybody dance. I said dance,
everybody, everybody, everybody,
everybody dance. Everybody dance. I said dance,
everybody, everybody, everybody,
everybody dance. Everybody dance. I said groove.
Everybody, everybody, everybody,
everybody, everybody groove. Everybody groove.
Waterfront is the name. Dan, I'm sorry, I thought you were going to roll that like we told you, but that we'll talk to the guys first. I wanted to give you a chance to catch your breath. I think I'll do that anyhow. You make me tired. We'll be right back. Watch this. Thank you, Colleen. And now back to Sissy and Bobby. You guys really tear it up. Well, you look like Flip Wilson, too. I read lips. Doesn't he, huh? Where else, folks, can you tune a show in on one day, see Edith Bunker, Flip Wilson, and Herbie Schultz, and Miss Davis over there raises hogs. Your real name is Leon, isn't it?
Yes, Leon Trent.
You even talk like Flip a little bit. Anybody ever tell you that before?
Yes, everybody but Flip, yeah.
Did you see Pete Rose when he came in to see you guys the other day, Leon?
Oh, yeah, he's over all the time, and we were up Lucy's last night, and he was the guest DJ up there. And
how did he do? I was wondering about
that. He was good. He was very good. Very, very good. I wouldn't advise him to quit playing ball, but he was very good.
He called me and did a number on you guys, said that he really had a good time, and I wasn't really sure because I didn't know what time of night it was he was there.
Well, he gets there when he's feeling, and you, yeah.
Well, I took his word for it because I didn't want him to hit me with that baseball bat the way he does, you know. Who are the rest of the guys in the group, Leon?
On trombone, this is Jeff Hackenberg.
Jeff.
On bass guitar, Mr. Corky Ray.
Okay.
Drummer in the back, also our illustrious leader. Good. I get an extra $5 for saying that. Our illustrious leader, Mr. Paul Caliendo.
Hello, Paul Caliendo. If not, he'll get the whole mafia after us.
That's
you know
right.
That, right?
I know what you mean. The gentleman on keyboards, Mr. Stan Carroll. Huh? Gentleman on guitar, Mr. Harry London.
Who scared him?
I don't know. I've been trying to get my hair like that for a long time. I still can't. His name is Jimmy Casale.
Jimmy Casale. How'd you get the name Waterfront?
Well, we're from Jersey, and we live on the waterfront, and there was a time when things were rather difficult as far as work was concerned, so we had a big house that we had rented, and it was on the waterfront, right on the ocean, and a lot of nights it got cold. So we always use that as something to think about when you do things like this show.
Get out on stage and say, I better do well. Back to the waterfront, right?